I have a set of camping pots that's nested, and they come in set of four. There's three here, and this is a new set. It has eight pieces consisting of four lids, and then there are four bowls. And I also have this lid from somewhere else, which fits this perfectly. And what I found was that this smallest pot, because it has a rim, it can actually put inside a coffee tin can here and fits perfectly. So this video is about how I use this coffee container to make it into a stove and use a can of baked beans to make it into a burner. Okay, we'll make a stove using two cans, a small little can and a big can. And we're going to use it to cook some chicken. That's a chicken. And I'm going to use this pot. And then for fuel, we're going to use the pellet. Just use one scoop. And for fire starter, we're going to use orange peel and alcohol, soaking some alcohol, and just put a couple of pieces on top of the wood pellet and to use that to start the fire. First thing to do is to punch eight holes on the bottom of this can. So there it is, eight holes. And we're going to make the holes a little bit bigger. So I use this and I just push this in, and now here are the holes. Okay. For the center air hole, we're going to use another can. We're going to cut a piece of metal from this and put it in the middle here. So there's a can, and then punch a hole through it. So there's the hole. So here is the metal. It's got a hole in it, and it goes right here. So cut one side square, one side slightly rounded to make it easier to put in. Okay, so I bend this. So I left this little piece of metal sticking out, and I bend it into this shape. And this piece of metal is needed because later on when I use this to fill the top, I can put this on top and then it would find a location. Okay. Okay, so there's that piece of metal. So it will allow air to go from both sides and go up the middle. And I made the holes a little bit bigger on the two sides. So next thing to do is to tie down that center thing with a piece of wire. So there it is. So I took a piece of wire and it goes on one side to the other, and then out this hole and into this hole, and then twist it inside. And on this side, same thing. Out this hole and in through this hole. Okay, now get a ruler and then draw a line that measures 6 centimeters from the bottom. So there's the line, 6 centimeters from the bottom. And then we have to make a cut, four cuts across, and then a little cut here, and a little cut here, and a little bit cut here. I'll draw it out. Okay, so there it is. So you can see from here, we need to cut from here to here, and then make a little cut right above here, and a little cut right above here, and then I'll cut down from here to here and one from side. And there are four of them. So that's the first one, second one, third one, and fourth one. Okay, so the cuts are done. So you can see, here's the result. Okay, and all four are cut. And inside looks like this. So now we'll bend the top part. We'll bend the top part along horizontally, and then bend this corner in. Okay, so I finished doing that. I'll just remove the paper so it's easier to see. So there it is. So the top part's bent in, bottom part's not, and the corner's bent in. There are four sides. So now take the big can, and this goes inside, and in order to see the flame, we need a hole on the side here. So this can is it's about 8 centimeters, so we need a hole about 9 centimeters to 10 centimeters here so you can see the flame, because we're going to look it from the top. And then we need 8 holes on top, all the way around, and some smaller holes on the bottom. Okay, I finished cutting the holes. So those are the cuts. And I removed the paper. So just fold them over. Okay, so there they are. Fold it over. So with this, I'll just cut a window here so I can see the flame. Okay, so I made 5 cuts. Horizontal cut, and then a cut to the top, cut to the bottom, cut here, and a cut here. And I'll fold these over. So there it is. That's our viewing portal. And then now I need some holes at the bottom. Okay, so I use this and I punch 12 square holes on the bottom. Maybe I'll need to use this and make them a little bit bigger. So there they are, 12 holes on the bottom. I think the holes on top are not. Let me punch a few more holes on top. Okay, now there are 12 holes on top and 12 on the bottom. So what I want to do was to make sure that the sum of the surface area of the holes is about the same as the top of this. So that's why I made these bigger. So this, put it here, and then take one scoop, put it there, so even out both sides, and then take the orange peel, and add some to each side. So it's about maybe 10, 12 pieces. And then, so there it is. And then we'll get the chicken. So there's a... So there's the chicken. And we'll add some ginger and green onion. And then we'll sprinkle a bit of salt. And then we'll fire it up. So basically, okay, so here we should be able to see the flame from this angle. And then the pot goes in this way. So this goes in here. And we can see this. But anyway, there's like about a 2 or 3 centimeter gap. And I'll put this on top. But first we have to light it. So we'll light the fuel and we'll cook it. So it's dark outside. Anyway, so here's the can. And there's the peeping hole. And then we have the small can with the fuel. And I got 2 matches. And we just light it up. So just light the match. Drop it in. Okay, so, and there's the chicken with ginger and green onion. Just pop this in. So there's a flame. So at the very beginning, this is going to be painting off, burning off a lot of paint. So it's going to really smell. So we just go inside. Besides, it's very cold outside right now. There's snow on the ground because it's about 30 degrees or about -2. So how's it going? So there's the flame. Should get a clock. Okay, so we started 1 or 2 minutes ago. So there's burning. Lots of heat coming from the side, so that's good. Oh, it smells really nice. Okay. So the bottom part is not too hot, but top part is very, very hot. Go here and take out, I should just peel it back in. And then I flip the chicken around to make sure they're nice evenly cooked. Flame's still burning strong. So the steam is coming from the chicken because I didn't put any water in. Okay, so I'll use this to grab the pot. See, take a look at the result. There's a chicken. Let's take it inside. Okay. Come, doggy. Come. Come, come. Okay, so I should. This is chicken. So they look fine. Look at the stove. Take out the fuel and empty this, and we'll take this inside. I'll take a look. So that would burn to ash if I kept it, but I don't need any more chicken stock. So looking at this, so there's, ooh, that's hot. So there's a bit of discoloration on the bottom, but not on the outside. Okay, so this looks fine. There's no change at all. Let's take a look at the pot. So this is chicken. And then well, the ginger and green onion. There it is. Oh, this is a mess. Let's see if we can wash it. Okay, let's take this to here. Okay, so after I wipe it with a sponge, it is still very, very dirty. So this needs some scrubbing before I use it again. And I think the reason why this is happening is because the fuel got too hot. The holes I made on the bottom are too big. So what I should do is make that again, but make it smaller holes. Actually, the other way of doing it, because I use the punch to punch the hole in, what I could do is just push back some of the metal to make the hole smaller. And that will allow less primary air, and then the bottom will not turn black, I'm hoping. Anyway, let's have some chicken.